Good morning. The position is a function of time of an object equals negative 0.689 times time squared plus 1.27 times time plus 1.20 meters. Let's determine the objects A, initial position, B, velocity function, C, acceleration function, D, position at 1.50 seconds, E, velocity at 1.50 seconds, and F, acceleration at 1.50 seconds. Bobby, please do part A.
Flippin' physics.
Part A is determining the initial position of the object. Well, the initial position is at time equals 0 seconds, so we substitute 0 into the position equation. Position at time 0 equals negative 0.689 times 0 squared plus 1.27 times 0 plus 1.2. That equals 1.2 meters. 1.20 meters with sig figs.
Correct, Bobby. Bo, please do part B.
Part B is where we determine the velocity function. We determined last time that the derivative of position with respect to time equals velocity. So let's take the derivative of the position function with respect to time. That equals 2 times negative 0.689 or negative 1.378 times time to the, well, 2 minus 1 equals 1, so times time to the first power, which is just time, plus, well, actually just 1.27, because the derivative of the constant 1.20 meters is 0. So the velocity function with correct sig figs and units equals negative 1.38 times time plus 1.27 meters per second.
Correct, Bo. Billy, please do part C.
Part C is where we determine the acceleration function. Acceleration equals the derivative of velocity with respect to time. That just equals negative 1.378 or negative 1.38 meters per second squared.
Correct, Billy. So, who can tell me what type of motion this object is experiencing?
It's uniformly accelerated motion.
How do you know that?
The acceleration equals a number. That's what uniformly accelerated motion means. The acceleration is constant.
Right.
Actually, let's take a short detour and determine the acceleration function of this position function. Bo, please?
The position function is position as a function of time equals 7 times time cubed minus 4 meters. Velocity equals the derivative of position with respect to time, or 21.0 times time squared meters per second. Acceleration equals the derivative of velocity with respect to time, or 42.0 times time meters per second squared.
This is not uniformly accelerated motion.
Right, because the acceleration is not constant. It changes as a function of time.
Okay, you could tell from just looking at the position equation for the motion of an object if an object is experiencing uniformly accelerated motion.
We can? How?
If the highest exponent in the position equation is 2 or less, the object is experiencing uniformly accelerated motion.
And if the highest exponent in the position equation is 3 or more,
the object is not experiencing uniformly accelerated motion.
Right. Because acceleration is the derivative of position with respect to time.
Absolutely correct, everybody. Now, I do want to highlight what Billy just said. Acceleration is the derivative of position with respect to time. In other words, acceleration is the second derivative of position with respect to time. And that is written as d squared x over dt squared. Okay, I also want to look at the velocity equation we derived for the object. Does it look familiar to anyone?
No.
Not really.
It is one of the uniformly accelerated motion equations.
Oh, yeah. It is velocity equals velocity naught plus acceleration times time. So the initial velocity of the object equals 1.27 meters per second.
And the acceleration of the object is negative 1.38 meters per second squared.
And the position equation for the object is also one of the uniformly accelerated motion equations. It is position equals position naught plus velocity naught times time plus 1/2 acceleration times time squared.
And it shows the initial position equals 1.20 meters, and the initial velocity equals 1.27 meters per second again.
And 1/2 times acceleration equals negative 0.689, so acceleration equals negative 1.38 meters per second squared.
Very nice. Okay, let's get back to the problem. Bo, please do parts D, E, and F.
Okay, we are trying to find the object's position, velocity, and acceleration at 1.50 seconds. We have equations for each of those functions as functions of time, so all we need to do is substitute 1.5 seconds into each equation, and we will get the answer. So position at 1.5 seconds equals negative 0.689 times 1.5 squared plus 1.27 times 1.5 plus 1.2. That equals negative 1.55035 plus 1.905 plus 1.2, or 1.554475, or 1.55 meters with three significant digits. Velocity at 1.5 seconds equals negative 1.378 times 1.5 plus 1.27, or negative 0.797 meters per second. And acceleration at 1.5 seconds equals, well, the acceleration is constant, so it does not matter what the time is. The acceleration always equals negative 1.38 meters per second squared.
Thanks, Bo. That is all correct. Now, so far, this is all just a bunch of numbers, but these equations actually represent the motion of an object in the real world. Could y'all please posit what object it could be and how it could be moving?
The object starts with a positive velocity and ends with a negative velocity.
Because it has a constant negative acceleration.
It could be a rocket moving forward in space that turns on its reverse thrusters.
Or a boat moving forward that throws the engine in reverse.
I like those two ideas, and they could be correct. However, this actually represents a cart moving up an incline, which experiences a constant acceleration down an incline. I'd like to add graphs of these functions as well, so we can see the motion of the cart and compare it to everything we see in the graphs. On the position as a function of time graph, you can see the initial position equals 1.20 meters, and the position after 1.50 seconds equals 1.55 meters. And you can also see those positions are real positions of the cart at those times of 0 and 1.50 seconds. On the velocity as a function of time graph, you can see the initial velocity equals 1.27 meters per second, and the velocity after 1.50 seconds equals negative 0.797 meters per second. On the acceleration as a function of time graph, you can see the acceleration is constant at negative 1.38 meters per second squared. But I would also like to point out one other piece of important information which can be seen from the graphs. Can anyone tell me what important thing happens to the cart at the point where the velocity function crosses the time axis?
I do not see anything special.
Me either.
It's on the position graph. The cart reaches its maximum position when the velocity function crosses the time axis.
Oh, right.
Exactly, Billy. When the derivative of a function equals zero, the function has a local maximum, a local minimum, or a turning point.
What?
What?
Right. Sorry. Velocity is the derivative of position with respect to time. When the derivative of a function equals zero, which is what happens when the derivative function crosses the time axis, the original function has a local maximum value, meaning the maximum value right near that time. A local minimum value, again, meaning the minimum value right near that time, or a turning point, like the function x cubed at the origin.
Okay, sure, that makes sense.
So we could determine the time at which the cart gets to its maximum height, right, Mr. P?
That is correct. Bobby, could you please do that?
Sure. We just set the velocity equation equal to zero and solve for time, right?
Yes, Bobby, that is correct.
Okay, so add 1.378 times time to both sides, and then solve for time. We get time equals 1.27 divided by 1.378, or 0.921626, or 0.922 seconds.
And we can calculate the maximum position there. We just substitute that time into our position equation, and we get 1.78523, or 1.79 meters, as the maximum position of the cart.
And notice that those two values, which you predicted using the equations, match the measured values of our demonstration. The cart reaches its maximum position at 0.92 seconds, and that maximum position is 1.79 meters because...
The physics works.
Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.